And intentionally, I wanted to make this sound as bad as I can make it sound. Okay.
What's your name, brother?
My name is John Jackson.
John Jackson.
The name of the book, the working title right now is Spooked. A perpetual whirlpool of confusion, disappointment, and unresolved emotional issues seems to be an adequate description of a large portion of my life. Unfulfilled dreams, missed opportunities, bad choices, and unrealized ambitions were recurring themes in my life. That rather dismal assessment of my life, while true, was due in part to my ignorance of basic moral life principles and the unfortunate reality of life in America for people of color. Getting involved with drugs would then magnify the flaws in my understanding tenfold. My frustration with my reality teetered so close to the edge of an abyss so deep and so dark that I found myself dizzy, in a free fall of mistakes from a place so high on a mountain of foolishness that I was sure to splatter once I hit bottom. I found myself surrounded by false faces on a broad road to self-destruction. Along with so many other unfortunate souls, I was riding a wave of oblivion, destined to crash on distant shores of desolation and destruction with no hope for rescue. It was hard to confront feelings of insecurity and low self-esteem. It was equally hard to admit that I just didn't get it. I didn't know how to voice the reality of those ravenous black holes of emotional pain that sucked the very gravity of my soul and left me floating in a void of numbness, clinging to slim threads of hope and desires that I didn't know how to fulfill. I longed for a light to shine on the darkness that had crept through the crevices of my naive and immature mind. I wanted desperately to experience something other than all the absurdities of my situation. I made so many bad choices. Confusing feelings flooded the depths of my soul and the loneliness of my thoughts. I couldn't think straight. I didn't feel right. Nothing made sense because I had developed the bad habit of making sense out of nonsense. I drifted deeper and deeper into the darkness that surrounded me. And before I fully realized the error of my way, I was standing in the rubble of my own self-destruction and continuing to dig the hole for my own grave. If only I had opted for safety and comfort in the realm of good common sense instead of crossing the threshold into the domain of the insane. If only I hadn't allowed myself to be drawn into the unjust, twisted, and maladjusted playground of the ridiculous. It was a community of sorrows without end, and like a fool, I was trying to make it real compared to what? So sad how a strong desire to be accepted can cause one to accept that which does more harm than good. I realize today that I accepted certain life situations and people into my life because they accepted me. And because of so many foolish decisions, I found myself trapped in the kind of crazy life that had me spooked.
Mm. Damn, man, thank so you, good. My brother. Thank you so much. Give him a hand, gentlemen. Yeah.
Old days.
Old days.